Mr. Wright is just going to walk right up, knock on your door, and say, here I am.
Oh, there you are.
Which side, the yellow or the green?
Green. It goes better with your eyes.
Huh, thanks.
Ma, I just want a guy that I can respect that respects me.
Then I'm sorry to bother you again. It's just I value your opinion. Gold? Gold or tiger's eye cufflinks?
Gold. Simple, elegant.
Right.
Who knows, Ma? I just think maybe someday he'll come along.
Fran, open your eyes. Life just doesn't work like that.
I think Lester and Jocelyn really looked happy.
Yes, they did. And to think they almost missed their chance.
Oh, I know. In this day and age, to have two people rule out love just because of class.
Imagine being blind to the fact that you love someone just because they work for you.
I know. It's unbelievable.
Yes, well, good night, Miss Fine.
Good night, Mr. Sheffield.
I was in love once. I say I was in love once.
Oh, I'm sorry. Niles, did you want to tell me about it?
Yes, it was Catherine, the housekeeper. We never spoke of it, but there were signs. A look, a wink, a shared laugh. But I never did anything about it. So she married someone else and I never saw her again. Of course, no one ever knew.
Oh, good God, man, the whole house knew. We were taking bets on when you two would get together. The incredible thing is, you let her get away.
Yes, I was remarkably stupid, wasn't I, sir? Mm.
Welcome back, Miss Fine.
Thank you, Mr. Sheffield. It's good to be back.
I just hope you made the right decision.
I did. Hello. What?
That's a good man.
Oh, excuse me, sir. If you don't mind my asking, doesn't Miss Leslie remind you of someone?
Oh, so you noticed it too.
Well, it is rather obvious, huh?
Yes, she is a dead ringer for Connie Selica. She is pretty unique, isn't she, Niles?
Whatever you say, sir.
Oh, careful there, man.
Oh, thank you, sir. Yes, you see, I should have used my oven mitt instead of this somewhat inferior substitution. But I didn't realize I wanted my oven mitt until I saw them together. And then I understood that, of course, my oven mitt is exactly what I wanted. And goodness gracious, it was under my nose the entire time.
Good. Glad you found it.
Thingy on. Now they're gonna have red eyes. Oh, boy. Are they a great couple or what? Boy, if they're not meant to be together, who is?
Miss Fine, doesn't Miss Leslie remind you of someone?
What am I, a radish? That hair, those clothes, that voice? She's a dead ringer for Audrey Hepburn. All I'm saying is that I need a guy that cares about what I think.
It's fine. What do you think? I've got these concert tickets for Maggie, but now I'm having second thoughts about letting her go.
You know, we're really in the middle of something here. Why don't you get another pair? We'll sit a couple of rows back. We'll keep an eye on her.
Oh, excellent idea, Miss Fine. What would I do without you?
All I'm saying is I need a guy who needs me. I need someone I can share things with. Thanks. I'm so
hot. You know, you're absolutely right. A good relationship has to be about give and take. Hmm? Oh, thank you. Yeah.
Besides, you have to have some stuff you can have in common.
Mm-hmm. Ketchup and mustard. Just the way I like it.
Sure.
What's this thing with her and Kurt? Why is it gnawing at me like this?
Well, perhaps you feel that he's not the right man for her, that she'd be happier with someone else.
That's absurd. They're perfectly suited to each other. So why do I find it so bloody irritating?
Oh, dear. That was the last apple.
Oh, I'm sorry, old man. Did you want it?
Well, yes, sir, but I didn't realize I wanted it until someone else had sunk his teeth into it, and now it's too late. God, it was right there in front of me. If only I'd snatched it up when I had the chance, I wouldn't have this aching hunger.
Good God, man, have a bloody pear.
Hi, Niles.
Hi, Fran. Going out with Kurt?
Guess well.
Well, you don't seem very excited.
Oh, I know. I should be nuts about the guy. I mean, he knows everything about me and he's still interested. I don't know. Maybe that's it. There's no mystery. It's like when you watch Columbo. 10 minutes into it, you know who did it. Then you spend the rest of the hour trying to figure out which one is the glass eye. What's wrong with me?
Oh, dear. That was the last pear.
Oh, I'm sorry. Did you want it?
Well, yes, but I didn't realize I wanted it until someone else had sunk his teeth into it.
Well, if you snooze, you lose.
Well, don't worry, Miss Fine. If it isn't Kurt, it'll be someone else. Good night, Miss Fine.
Good night, Mr. Sheffield. You know, I'm not asking for much, really. I just want someone that's going in the same direction as me.
I know exactly what you mean.
Dear Fran, this is my last letter. When I came in and saw you with that great-looking guy, I knew I could never compete with him.
Oh, Miss Fine, I feel terrible.
You? What were the odds of Lenny walking in just when I was in the arms of David?
Well, I suppose when two people spend as much time around each other as those two, something like this is bound to happen.
Yeah, I suppose it's inevitable.
You thinking what I'm thinking?
What are you thinking?
I'm thinking about taking a shower and going to bed. Oh, it's no good, Niles. I can't concentrate. It's too bloody quiet. What on earth's missing?
Well, perhaps this will help, sir.
Oh, Mr. Sheffield.
That's it. Niles, Miss Fine's not here.
Well, just trying to fill your void, sir. It's obvious you miss her.
I most certainly do not. I'm just wondering where she is, what she's doing. Which is entirely different from missing her. What?
Oh, nothing, sir. I was just wondering how you ended up there and I ended up here.
But I'm afraid I wouldn't know the right woman for me if she fell out of the sky.
Sheffield, you know, the psychic told me that I would dance on water with the man of my dreams. What a waste of money that was.
Well, it's about bloody time. I asked for this bottle hours ago.
Well, good things come to those who wait. Mm. Unless they wait too long and then they slip through their namby-pamby fingers.
You know, Fran, I could have sworn when Max just walked in, you acted as if you were cheating on him.
No, just because I pushed you off of me and started to act defensive.
Were you planning on seeing Nigel tonight?
Well, I was thinking about it, but if you don't want me to, if you think my place is to be here with you and the kids, just say the word.
Oh, by all means, go. You two will have a wonderful time together. Yeah, who knows when I'll finish up in the office. Oh, please don't sit around waiting for me.
All right. Did you know how he felt about me?
Did I know? For 4 years, I've been hinting to him, I've been hinting to you, I've been hinting to him to hint to you. Why do you think I don't have enough time to make pate?
Well, if something happens to her, she'll never know how I feel about her. No one knows.
No one...
Hello?
What's C.C. right? I mean, have I let my judgment be impaired by my feelings for Miss Fine?
What feelings are those, sir?
Well,
no, I don't, sir.
Oh, come on, Niles.
Oh, but you'd feel so much better if you just said it.
Oh, perhaps you're right. Maybe I should just admit that I...
Knock,
that...
knock.
Oh, wait! What do I have to do to convince her she's desirable?
Oh, sir, I'm sure you'll think of something. I mean, after all, you're a man, she's a woman. Fill in the blank. The children are at school, she's lying on the sofa, and if all else fails, what would Pierce Brosnan do?
I don't know what the woman wants anymore. What am I supposed to do?
May I speak freely, sir?
Yes, of course, old boy.
I am so bloody sick of hearing this year after year. Niles, what am I to do? I told her I loved her. I took it back. I'm afraid of commitment. I'm worried about the children. For God's sake, make a move! Do something! You cast off caps! Do you want to regret this for the rest of your life, too?